Engineerable.
We're going to attach this clear resin rod that's made out of alumilite resin to this skull in order to suspend the skull and the resin and create a almost transparent suspension method. The only things I've found that are fully transparent in resin is resin itself. So I make these rods out of resin using coffee stirring straws to cast the rods. So I pour the resin into the coffee stirring straws. The results are pretty good of this. The only thing that would improve is the more polished the interior surface, the more polished the surface, the more it disappears and the more transparent it is. So these are the steps. So the first thing to do is cut the end off. You can use some snips, you can use an X-Acto. So in this case, this end is bad. I'm gonna cut it off to get a fresh end, fresh tip. There we go. Actually, it actually cuts a little bit. It kind of fractures. Doesn't really cut that well. So just get a clean cut on the end. That to be perfect. And then we're going to apply some UV glue to the face here. And I'm probably just going to go ahead and just fill up the nose cavity so you won't really notice it as much because it's in the nose cavity with the glue, and then apply the UV light to bond it. Yeah, I can use something to prop up the skull like that. So I'm going to put the UV resin in the skull and use this helping hand. To hold that place. All right, so first thing is take this UV resin and kind of shake the bottle down a little bit when it's been sitting upright, get it to go near the bottom, and we're gonna put it in that nasal cavity. And fill up that cavity. There we go. So I'll just set the bottle on its side, so if I do more, then I don't have to refill the whole thing. And then I'm gonna put the rod down in there. I'm trying to make sure there's no like air bubbles in the resin. Okay. Put the resin out of sight of the UV lamp. Put on the UV goggles and cure it with this UV lamp. This is a 365 nanometer curing resin, so it's a 365 nanometer UV LED flashlight. And you want to make sure you're wearing eye protection for this. So wear the UV protecting glasses. And it cures pretty quickly. So then the only place it doesn't cure is on the surface, because it in the presence of oxygen inhibits a curing on the surface. So then I'm going to take it and dip it in a water bottle that I use for curing. So here, I can already pull this out now. Dip it in this water bottle. And going to submerge UV light in there too. And you can see it to kind of to angle it towards it, but it's going to cure the part on the surface that wasn't curing before. It doesn't take that long for this glue to cure, but I just want to make sure that it's fully cured. And then before I can cast the resin is sensitive to humidity, so I'm going to have to make sure that this is fully dry before I do the resin. So I'm going to put this in the drying rack in the oven for a little while. And you can test using the tip of an X-Acto. Can see if it's hardened on the surface, and this has hardened on the surface. There we go, that one's ready. Gotta get some air to blow out the excess water. Here's another example of gluing it using the resin rods in a different application. Well, same application, just different item. So we're bonding to it in a different way. So in this case, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna glue it on the inside of the mouth of this raptor skull, like in here somewhere. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna apply the UV resin on the inside of the mouth, top of the skull here. It's coming out. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and put a little bit on the tip here. And you don't want an excessive amount of the UV. You only want as much as you're gonna need. So what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna hold it, I'm gonna hold it in place with one hand, make sure it's lined up. In this case, we'll put it like this, line it up. Move the resin bottle away and shine the UV light on it for a few seconds. And it's already mostly bonded. So that looks good. Looks good. Looks like where we want it. So I'm going to finish curing it. And cure it a little bit longer. It's the UV. Now we're going to do the underwater curing. So I dip it in the water, put the light underwater here, and cure it underwater a little bit. Here you can just see, you can see a tiny glow. You don't see the glow like you did with the skull because it's only glowing in where the UV glue is. Should be good. Now we're gonna blow off some excess water. There we go. We've got the skull set up on the resin rod, so it will be practically transparent when we put in the resin. To suspend the rods inside the resin, I make this very simple holder where I put two pieces of elastic and then put the rod on there. And then put two pieces of elastic on the other side. The reason I use two pieces of elastic is sometimes the elastic breaks, especially if some resin gets on it. So two will kind of have a failsafe. There we go. And now we can have something that's pretty easily repositionable and will sit atop the mold.